world's biggest hassle. First, you have to wear a
suit.
Well,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah, well, you know, when you go to jail, you know, it makes you think.
Yeah.
And I said, you know, all this, like, that was just an emotional reaction at the time, you know, because at the time I didn't have any distinction between playing an arena and playing CBGBs.
Yeah.
And if I was playing CBGBs and I did that, Kurt Loder wouldn't have been talking about it on MTV, you know, because it didn't matter. But if you know, you can't do that. You can't jump in there and kick somebody's ass, you know. I'm not going to do it again.
Yeah.
If it happens again, I'll just, like, you know, walk off the stage. I mean, I'm on probation right now for physical assault, and if I punch, you know, one more person, that's it. No more Skid Row, you know. So somehow I really don't think that's worth it, you know.
So you're reining yourself in.
Control Your Demons tour. That's what I call this. Control Your Demons. Come out, you know, and get out. Get down, boy, you know.
Let's talk about this AIDS shirt, because I think that pissed a lot of people off, or angered a lot of AIDS activists.
Yeah,
what was going on there? You show up in a photo wearing a shirt that says AIDS kills fags.
Right. Well,
surely there's a story there.
I mean, this is, you know, it won't seem, you won't believe this probably, but at the time, I swear, I did not know that anybody gave a flying whatever what it said on my chest. You know what I mean? That was like the introduction into responsibility for me.
Yeah.
And, you know, actually it really hit home because one of my friends is a homosexual in New York, and really, really good friend.
Yeah.
And he just let me know exactly what it meant to him, that shirt. And I felt like, you know, Fred Flintstone in Mr. Slate's office. Did I shake it down in the chair?
Did he call you up and explain it?
No,
nah,
he
really
got
bad.
Me backstage, and he was mad.
Yeah.
And he had every right to be, because a lot of his friends died, and that's not cool. Making fun of that.
Yeah. Where did the shirt come from?
It was thrown to me on stage. I didn't even know what set I put it on.
So it doesn't represent your sympathies.
No, I mean that's, there's nothing funny about death.
No.
You think
things have maybe gone too far? And
everyone's nailed it home was walking down a street and having a 12-year-old guy in a Skid Row shirt come up to me and goes, "Hey, I hate faggots too."
Oh.
And I went, wrong. You know, that's a very wrong vibe to put out to people.
Yeah. So you think more about these things.
Oh, yeah.
I would imagine.
Unfortunately, yes, I do.
you had a son recently. Let's talk about him. Mm-hmm. He's really cute, I thought. What you decided not to, you were told, I guess, not to tell people you had a kid, but
you know, there's something really, really strange when you're respected, like the people that like Skid Row respect us for being, like, honest about everything, you know, and playing music that is honest and, you know, not a big scam or a big front. Anything.
Yeah.
So I found it very hypocritical when I would have my son out to see a show that I would have to go in a different door in the hotel than him. And I said, "This is over, man. I don't care." You know, they said, "Oh, but all these chicks, you know, they really dig you." And I go, "They're not stupid. You know, they don't want to be like treated like a bunch of idiots."
No.
You know, I think that people underestimate the intelligence of rock bands. If they figure, like, people at record companies figure that they want to hear the same song done, written by the same guy with the same lead solo, with the same chorus, with the same lyrics, you know, and every front man is a rock hunk, and, you know, he's in Doom Metal Stud Monthly, you know, and you can't have kids, can't be a human, you know, all this stuff. People are people, man, you know.
So are you plagued by fans here at all? I mean, this is pretty remote where
sometimes
we are.
Sometimes,
yeah. How do they find you?
I don't know, man. I get calls from, like, Alabama and Texas and
Japan. How do they find your number?
I don't know. All you hear is this. Sebastian there? Who's this? Click. I'm like,
So you change your phone number a lot.
Yeah, once a week. Well, I have a goofy line upstairs and a good line down here.
What's a goofy line?
You give it to the goofy people.
Sebastian Bach, this month's Rolling Stone cover boy, will be leading Skid Row out on a headlining U.S. tour this fall. Joining us right now is MTV's House of Style host, Cindy Crawford. Cindy, I'm glad you're here. You're looking fine.
Oh, thanks, Kurt. How are you?
So you're here tonight. Prince is here tonight, a man who actually wrote a song about you once.
Yeah, that's sort of my big thrill for tonight, hopefully, is I'm going to go and see if I can meet him. He wrote a song on his Black album.
Yes,
called Cindy C, which I've heard, but I couldn't really figure out what he was saying. A little bit.
judging by the rest of the stuff on that record, who knows what he's saying.
There's a reason that it wasn't released, right?
So you're gonna be covering the whole backstage thing, right?
Yeah, I think I'm gonna be in the green room and also where they're doing all the video production.
Yeah.
Sort of. I know they're gonna be hectic back there, so they're probably not gonna want me invading their space. And also just watching as people pull up and all that stuff.
And you'll be on stage too, right?
Yeah, presenting. I'm presenting best long form video, I think. But also, I found out I might be presenting with a special guest also, and they don't want to go out by themselves. So.
A special guest. Okay, we'll look forward to that. Let me give you this ribbon. This is being
what
put
is
out
this?
By
I saw you had one.
Broadway Equity Visual Aids, and it's to remind people that the fight against AIDS goes on 10 years later.
I will wear it, probably.
Okay, thanks very much. We're going to take another quick break right now, but we'll be back with Cindy and an REM report. Almost lost it there, so don't go away.
Back to